Joining us now from NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, is Dr. Doug Morton, who's going to talk to us about wildfires. Let's talk about this year's wildfire season. What have you seen so far?
The 2013 fire season has been a pretty active year across the western U.S. We got an early start in Southern California with fires in May, and that's just continued straight on through with damaging wildfires across parts of Arizona and Colorado, some of the most damaging in history in terms of the loss of property. This fire season actually represents a somewhat average fire year when you look at the total amount of burned area. And that's something we can do using NASA satellites to look at how this year compares to previous years over the last 40 years.
So NASA has been monitoring fires from space for about three decades. What are some of the trends that you're seeing?
Across the United States, we've seen a large increase in the total amount of burning over the last 30 years. When we look globally, we see a similar trend with an increasing number of fires across areas like Southern Africa, the Amazon Brazilian deforestation arc, as well as areas in Siberia. So these large wildfires are something that we can see with the variety of satellites we have here at NASA from space.
What do projections show for the future?
Hot and dry conditions are really needed to have a large wildfire. And as we look out using the latest generation of climate models, we see areas of the United States that are already prone to fires getting hotter and drier, here shown in shades of red, and as well as the fact that we see areas that today aren't at risk of large wildfires becoming at a greater risk of those fires by the end of this century. Areas like the upper Midwest or the Great Plains.
So how are NASA satellites flying some 400 miles above the Earth used to detect and monitor wildfires?
At NASA, we have 14 different satellites that are observing the Earth at all times. Those satellites give us an opportunity to study fires globally. Satellites like NASA's Landsat series allow us to look at a detailed opportunity of mapping out individual fires and their burn scars. Other satellites are used to actively detect those fires and distribute that information in near real time. We even use other satellite sensors to study the smoke that gets released by those fires. And we can combine all of that information into a global model that allows us to look at where fires are burning and how the aerosols, the smoke and particulate matter that gets released from those fires, mixes into our atmosphere and helps us understand the Earth as a system.
Learn and see more.
This information and much more is available at nasa.gov/fires, with additional information about the individual satellites and the scientists that use the data from those satellites to better understand how fires are changing our natural ecosystems and our human societies.
Dr. Doug Morton, thanks so much.
Thank you.